So I often see that Mac users have a file or two that they're accessing all the time and they want to have easy access to it. So instead of putting it in the Documents folder, they put it maybe on the desktop. So let's take a look, for instance, here in a Finder window. I'm going to look under a subfolder and I've got a file called Daily Journal. And say this is something I need to open every day and write something in it. So you can see how going into my Documents folder and then in a Project A and then finding it here and opening it, it's a few too many steps. So a lot of people will just move it to the desktop and it lives there on the desktop. And they can easily open it by double clicking it there. But I don't like this solution because I'd rather have this file where it should be, properly filed in the proper subfolder in my Documents folder where I want it to be. So how can you still have easy access to it while at the same time having it reside in the proper place? So here's one option to get easy access to it while leaving it in its proper place. Instead of dragging it to the desktop, I'm going to drag it to the desktop, but before I release I'm going to hold down the Command and the Option key. And you see how the arrow there changes to a little curve? This means instead of copying the file there, it's going to leave an alias, or sometimes called a shortcut, to the file. The file is still there, but you can see here this little arrow, and that tells me that this is an alias to that file. And I could double click this one to open it. The file lives here, and I could still double click it to open it there. But this alias is kind of a shortcut that lives on my desktop. It gives me easy access to the file. I can even select it and delete it, and the original file still stays there. All I've done is gotten rid of the shortcut. So that's one way to do it if you really like to use the desktop. However, I like to keep a clean desktop. So there are other ways to do it. Like for instance, I can drag this file to the dock, to the right side of the dock, add it here. And that also creates an alias. Does it automatically. I don't have to hold down any special keys. You can see the original file is here, but there's a shortcut to it in the dock. Now a single click opens the file. And I always have access to the file by just going down to the dock and clicking on it. You also have two ways to add a shortcut to a file to the Finder window itself. One is to drag it over to the Favorites section here. But don't just drag it over there because that will then allow you to drop it into one of these folders and move it. You don't want to do that. You want to add a shortcut to it. So you want to drag while holding the Command key down and then you can insert it in between items. You can still drop it into something like that. But say if I wanted to put it between applications and desktop here, I can do it. Now you can see that I've got that file as a favorite there. It's still in its regular location, but I can easily open it with one click in the Finder Favorites. You can also add it to the toolbar up here. So you would drag with the Command key held down and you can see you got a plus button there and you can add the file there and it's in every Finder window. One click opens it up. Incidentally, to get rid of these things you can drag this off using Command. You have to hold down Command, drag it off and it goes away. The same thing with the sidebar here. I can actually, I don't even need to use Command. I can just drag it far enough away and I see it changes to an X. In the dock down below, I can drag that up and out. I have to drag it pretty high up before I can see the remove indicator there. And that's how you can get rid of those from those different items.